nothing will last forever. You can carve it on rock, you can carve it on gold, you can carve it on diamond, as you like. If you think it helps, you carve it on diamond when you can afford. Later you might not be able to do that. You might not be able to afford it. When you can, you do it. But it doesn't really help you, because diamond is not suffering. It is you who is suffering. Okay? So you can write 10,000 years of everlasting happiness on highest carat diamond, 10 feet wide and 5 feet long. You know? It's okay, it will stay there. And lots of people will try to get it. So, but you will be able to see it maybe once or twice, then you are back to square one. So this way, all aspects of situation in life in samsara is impermanent. So that is the second aspect of suffering. The third aspect of suffering is, long as we are dualistic, and base of dualism is I, then suffering of samsara will continue and there is no end. I can never achieve everlasting achievement until I overcome I. And when I overcome I, then the limited transform into limitless. Dualism transform into non-dualism. Until that happens, suffering of samsara is inevitable. So that is the third aspect of samsara, that's suffering.
Now, the second noble truth is truth of cause and conditions of suffering. To be brief, that is two things. First is karma. The second is defilement. Defilement, which I already told you. Attachment.
Attachment, anger, jealousy, pride, etc. That is defilement. So the cause and conditions of suffering, first thing is defilement. And other aspect is the karma. Karma is actually caused by defilement, derived from defilement, and accumulated by defilement. Anything that you think or you say or you do based on I is karma. How serious karma or not so serious karma, it depends. If our monkey friend hold on to the mango too hard and wish that all the other monkeys will not get such mango but him, then it's very serious karma. But he enjoys it, and he also wish that all the other monkeys also get the same mango, then not too bad. And if he shares half of his mango with other monkeys, then pretty good karma. So that way, it depends your intention. If your intention is purely good, sincerely good, then it is good karma. And if your intention is purely bad and sincerely bad, then it is very serious bad karma. Okay? And if your intention is wishy-washy but good, then it is all right. But good, but all right, not too noble. If your intention is bad but wishy-washy, that's also pretty much the same. It's bad but not too bad. So how serious karma is depends on how serious you are. So when I went to the